Now that we know we need to exercise the boundaries and there might be bugs in there, let's actually automate those tests. NJUnit 5 actually has a very nice feature that does help us to write all these tests. Let's start with the total is just too big partition. What we are going to do is to write one automated test for each one of the four boundaries we thought of in the previous video. So, if we provide small equals 1, big equals 1, and total equals 5 as inputs, we expect the output to be 0. If we provide small equals 1, big equals 1, total equals 6, we expect the output to be 1. And so on and so forth. One option would be to create more than one test for the same partition. Something like total is too big, 1, 2, 3, etc. However, as you can imagine, the number of tests could grow too fast and then become hard to maintain. And in terms of code, these tests would be very similar. The only thing that would change is the inputs and then the expected output. Thus, instead of writing one test method for each of these inputs, we'll use what JUnit calls a parameterized test. So let's write the template of our test method. It instantiates the chocolate bags class, invokes the calculate method, and makes an assertion. However, instead of passing the concrete inputs to calculate and then to the assertion, we can pass variables. In JUnit, we can receive parameters in the method and use them in our test. And that's what we'll do. The first three will be for the inputs, small, big, and total. The fourth one will be for the assertion. After all, the input is abstracted away, so leaves the assertion. Next, we should pass the concrete values we expect JUnit to use when running the test. And we do this by means of strings. For example, the first test would be small equals 1, big equals 1, total equals 5, and expected equals 0. We separate these values with commas. We do the same for the next. Small equals 1, big equals 1, total equals 6, and expected equals 1. And all of them. For JUnit to understand it, we put all these strings inside the @CSV source annotation. After all, the parameters are comma-separated values. As you can see, it receives an array of strings as parameter. Each parameter is a test case that will be executed individually by JUnit. Finally, we need to annotate this method as a test method. And as we are using a parameterized test and CSV as source, we should use @parameterizedTest instead. When we run this test, JUnit will get each of the strings, parse it, and then invoke the total is too big test method, passing each of the values as parameter. For example, for the first execution, JUnit will take the first string and then send the first value, 1, to the small parameter. The second value, also 1, to the big parameter. And the third value, 5, to the total parameter. And the fourth parameter, 0, to the expected parameter. That would be the same as executing a normal JUnit test with the concrete parameters. But now JUnit executes 4 tests instead of 1. And we can even see it when we run the tests. The output shows total is too big, and then 4 executions. And one of them is failing due to the bug which we'll fix later. Then, we should repeat it to all other partitions and boundaries we have identified. For example, for the only big bars partition, the automated test would look like this. Notice the values as CSV source. After doing it for the remaining two partitions, if we execute the tests, that's the output we'll see. 20 tests being executed, and 4 of them are failing. So we indeed have a bug, and let's fix it. If we go back to production code, we can see that the bug relies on the if line. If the comparison should not be smaller than or equals to, but only smaller than. Getting confused between smaller than and smaller than or equals to is definitely a bug that software developers do all the time. And just to make sure we fixed the bug, we executed tests again, and they are now all green. Well done, testers.